The Ship of Death by D.H. Lawrence.
And I have felt a presence that disturbs me with the joy of elevated thoughts, a sense sublime of something far more deeply interfused, whose dwelling is the light of setting suns, and the round ocean, and the living air, and the blue sky, and in the mind of man, a motion and a spirit that impels all thinking things, all objects of all thought, and rolls through all things. Therefore am I still a lover of the meadows and the woods and mountains and of all that we behold from this green earth.
We are dying. We are dying, so all we can do is now to be willing to die and to build the ship of death to carry the soul on the longest journey. A little ship with oars and food and little dishes, and all accoutrements fitting and ready for the departing soul. Now launch the small ship. Now, as the body dies and life departs, launch out the fragile soul in the fragile ship of courage, the ark of faith with its store of food and little cooking pans and change of clothes, upon the flood's black waste, upon the waters of the end, upon the sea of death, where still we sail darkly, for we cannot steer and have no port. There is no port. There is nowhere to go, only the deepening blackness darkening still blacker upon the soundless, ungurgling flood. Darkness at one with darkness. Up and down and sideways, utterly dark. So there is no direction anymore, and the little ship is there, yet she is gone. She is not seen, for there is nothing to see her by. She is gone, gone, and yet somewhere she is there. Nowhere. And everything is gone. The body is gone, completely under. Gone, entirely gone. The upper darkness is heavy as the lower. Between them the little ship is gone. It is the end. It is oblivion. And yet out of eternity a thread separates itself on the blackness. A horizontal thread that fumes a little with pallor upon the dark. Is it illusion? Or does the pallor fume a little higher? Oh, wait, wait, for there's the dawn. The cruel dawn of coming back to life out of oblivion. Wait. Wait, the little ship drifting beneath the deathly ashy grey of a flood dawn. Wait, wait. Even so, a flush of yellow and strangely, O chilled one soul, a flush of rose. A flush of rose and the whole thing starts again. The flood subsides, and the body, like a worn seashell, emerges strange and lovely. And the little ship wings home, faltering and lapsing on the pink flood, and the frail soul steps out, into the house again, filling the heart with peace. Swings the heart, renewed with peace, even of oblivion. Oh, build your ship of death, oh, build it, for you will need it, for the voyage of oblivion awaits you.